हेलो स्टूडेंट, दिस इज़ योर एक्सपेरिमेंट नंबर 23 टू स्टेलाइज सिरिंजेस, नीडल्स, ग्लासवेयर्स। एंड इन दिस एक्सपेरिमेंट वी आर गोइंग टू स्टेलाइज दिस इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स एपरेटस बाय डिफरेंट स्टेलाइजेशन मेथड्स। ओके, सो इन लास्ट वीडियो ओनली आई एक्सप्लेन यू स्टेलाइजेशन एंड डिफरेंट मेथड्स ऑफ स्टेलाइजेशन। नाउ हियर यू कैन सी द जनरल मेथड फॉर स्टेलाइजेशन ऑफ दिस सिरिंजेस, नीडल्स एंड द इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स एंड द ग्लासवेयर्स। Okay, so first you have to clean it with the detergent water, then you have to rinse it with water, and then you have to air dry it. After air drying, you have to wrap it in a muslin paper or a brown paper, and then you have to load it in the sterilizer. After sterilization, you have to cool it and allow it to unload and allow it to keep it in a sterilized area only. Okay, now here some apparatus has given: syringes, beaker, measuring cylinder and metal needle. Okay, so first we will see the syringe. This is a glass syringe. Okay, it is having two parts. This is barrel and this is a plunger. Okay, in market you can find two types of the syringes, mainly glass syringe and plastic syringes are used. Okay, so this is a nozzle of this syringe, this is syringe barrel. Okay, this is finger grip. Okay, then this is a plunger. Here in plastic syringes you can see the piston is there, plastic piston, rubber piston is there, but in glass syringes it is not there. Okay, then this is a push button of the syringe. Okay, so we have to sterilize this glass syringes by dry heat sterilization method. Okay, so first I will explain you the method. Sterilization of glass syringes is done by two different method, that is dry heat sterilization and moist heat sterilization. Okay, for all different types of sterilization of the syringes, glassware, needles, then a glassware, the measuring cylinder, then round bottom flask, the procedure is same. Okay, for the cleaning of the all these glass syringes and the glassware and the needles. Okay, so first you have to separate the barrel and the plunger of the syringes, and then you have to rinse it with the tap water immediately after use to remove the dry deposits like blood, proteins and cells. Okay, then soak the barrels and plungers in hot mild detergent solution. Use a smooth test tube brush for cleaning of inner side of the barrel and to prevent the scratches on it. Now repeat this rinsing for 3 to 4 times so that you can remove all the detergent particles. Okay, so first you have to rinse it with the hot tap water and then finally with the freshly distilled water. Allow the barrel and plungers to air dry or in a hot air oven at 65 degrees Celsius for 15 minutes. After sterilization, after drying, you have to inspect for the cleanliness and the other defects, whether it is having any particle remaining. Okay, after drying, you have to wrap it wrap the barrel and plunger with muslin wrappers and separately, and tighten the barrel and the plunger with thread to avoid its cross mixing. Load the wrapped barrel and plungers in the oven by maintaining the sufficient space for easy hot air circulation inside the oven. Okay, so here holding temperature is 170 degrees Celsius and holding time is 1 hour. You have to sterilize this for 1 hour at 170 degrees Celsius in hot air oven. After sterilization timing, you have to switch off the hot air oven, allow it to cool, and then you have to open it hot air oven and remove the sterilized glass syringes. After sterilization, you have to keep it in sterile area only. Now second method is moist heat sterilization. Okay, in moist sterilization we are using autoclave. Here the cleaning procedure is same for the syringes. After cleaning and after drying, you have to wrap this plunger and the barrel with the muslin wrappers, and then you have to tie it with the thread to avoid its mixing. Okay, then arrange the packet side by side in the SS sterilizing bin. Place the sterilizing bin in the autoclave and sterilize it for 121 degree Celsius for 20 minutes at 15 per square LBS per square inch pressure. After sterilization, we have to allow it to cool, switch off the autoclave and then allow it to cool. After cooling, open the lid of an autoclave and remove the sterilized material and then close the steam inlet of the SS sterilizing bin immediately. Remove the sterilized material from the SS sterilizing bin whenever required. Okay, now second sterilization is for the metal needles. Here you can use a dry heat sterilization method and moist heat sterilization method both. Okay, so for dry heat sterilization, we have to clean the needles with tap water immediately after its use by protecting its tip during washing. Insert a stylet or a needle wire through the hub to prevent by any blocking or obstruction in the needle. ओके मतलब जो नीडल है उस जब हम यूज़ करते हैं एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन करते हैं किसी पेशेंट को, उसके बाद आपको वो इमिजिएटली क्लीन करना है. अगर कोई ब्लड क्लॉट है वो तो हमें रिमूव करना है, तो वो रिमूव करने के लिए हम स्टाइलेट और नीडल वायर यूज़ कर सकते हैं. ओके नाउ कीप दिस नीडल इन हॉट अल्कलाइन डिटर्जेंट फॉर 30 मिनट्स टू रिमूव द ब्लड क्लॉट सेल्स प्रोटीन्स पार्टिकल्स विच अडहर टू द नीडल्स. वॉश दिस नीडल फ्रॉम इनसाइड एंड आउटसाइड प्रॉपरली. Then you have to flush the cannula with the help of the syringe for high pressure washing and clean the hub with the help of the cotton applicator. Finally, flush it with the freshly prepared distilled water. Now to inspect the tips of the needle under the magnifying lenses for its cleanliness and the sharpness. If the needles are not sharpened, then you have to resharpen it with the help of a fine stone or Arkansas stone if necessary. Air dry all the needles or dry in hot air oven at 65 degrees Celsius for 15 minutes. After that, you have to place these needles in special glass containers in suspended portion and then load the containers in the hot air oven by maintaining sufficient space for easy hot circulation inside the hot air oven. Carry out the sterilization in hot air oven with usual precautions under the different conditions, like temperature is 170 degrees Celsius and holding time is 1 hour. After sterilization for 1 hour, you have to switch off the oven and allow it to cool and open the hot air oven and unload the sterilized metal needles. These needles, these syringes are open whenever you want to use it or whenever you want to administer any injection to the patient. That time only you can open the packing of this syringes and the needles. Now here you can see I have taken the syringe, pipette, beaker, measuring cylinder, funnel and the round bottom flask and the volumetric flask, okay, which I have already cleaned it and dried it in hot air oven. Now I will wrap it and keep it in the hot air oven for sterilization. Now I will show you how to wrap the syringe. Okay, you have to separately wrap the barrel and the plunger of the syringe. Okay, after wrapping, you have to tie it with the thread like this. Okay, so that the wrapping paper will not come out from the syringe. Now I will show you how to wrap the pipette. Like this you have to wrap it. And again you have to tie it with the thread. Like this. Now here this is hot air oven and I have already set the temperature. Okay. Now you have to open this. You can see this. I have kept this pipette and the syringe and the plunger separately to sterilize it. Okay, after sterilization for 1 hour, you have to just switch off the hot air oven and then you have to cool it and then you have to remove the sterilized material. Okay, and you have to store it in the sterile area. Whenever you want to use this apparatus, syringes or the pipette, that time only you have to open this packing. Okay, thank you.